Hello students, we learn about some interesting facts about blood. Blood consists of plasma and the blood cells. Plasma comprises of 55% of the entire blood and blood cell comprises of 45% of the entire blood. The blood cells are RBC, WBC and platelets. RBCs are also called as erythrocytes, WBCs are called as leukocytes and platelets are called as thrombocytes. These blood cells, they are present in pale yellow liquid which is called as plasma. Blood cells are produced in the marrow of the long bones. Now let me remind you, marrow is not present in all the bones, they are only present in the long bones. Now you might be wondering how much blood is present in our human body. 5 liters of blood is present in a normal human adult. Now let's learn about the blood cell in a little more detail. RBC, which is also called as red blood cell or erythrocytes, they are biconcave disc-like cells. Biconcave disc-like structure of RBC makes them more efficient to move through the thin and narrow capillaries. These RBCs are red in color because of a pigment called as hemoglobin. The next blood cell is the WBCs. WBCs are also called as leukocytes and they are the soldiers, the defenders of our body. They are white in color and they do not have presence of a pigment called as hemoglobin. The third blood cell is called as blood platelets. Blood platelets are also called as thrombocytes and they help in clotting of blood. Right? What happens if you get injured? The blood starts oozing out of your body. So whether the blood keeps on flowing or it stops after some time, certainly it stops after some time. So what is the function of the platelets over here? Platelets, they're going to form the platelet plug at the injured place. But platelets do not function alone. They need number of factors for their functioning. One of the cofactors is vitamin K. So the delay in clotting is due to deficiency of vitamin K in our body. You all might have learned about ABO blood grouping system and you all might be knowing about antigen A and antigen B. And these two antigens have resulted in 4 different blood groups, blood group A, blood group B, blood group AB and blood group O. On the basis of this information, let's tabulate the donors and the recipients. So in this table, you can see that AB blood group can receive blood from all the blood groups and O can donate the blood to all the blood groups. That is why AB is called as universal recipient and O is called as universal donor. Why O is called as universal donor? Because it does not have the antigen. But there is a catch here. Although O does not have antigen, yet it has antibody. And this antibody in blood group O can react with A and B antigens present in the recipient. So, if the blood group has to be transfused, first the plasma is removed along with the antibodies. And only the blood cells are transfused in the recipient. And the blood cells do not have antigen. So, this is how O becomes universal donor. Now on the basis of this explanation, fill up the exercises.